Hi, welcome back to Tammy's Beauty Tutorials. How's everybody doing tonight? I am going to be doing an inspired look by a movie tonight, and it's going to be Addams Family Values, and I'm going to be doing Wednesday Addams. And so my hair's not ready, my face isn't ready, and so and the reason why I decided to start off this way, because you know, usually my hair is done or something's done, because it's pigtails, so that's pretty easy. I'll go off camera and do that. I just wanted to kind of start with a fresh face, fresh hair, you know, nothing done. Because last night I actually filmed this and, you know, I didn't have the look exactly where I wanted it. And so I kind of wanted to start, you know, because I thought about not doing the foundation on camera at all. So that way I can get it right and then show it to you. But then I thought, well, you know what? Maybe they would want to see the foundation because it's not like a normal foundation because it's white foundation. You know, like for Halloween and stuff. Maybe, you know, it would be valuable. So if I can kind of figure it out and get kind of figure out a trick to it, maybe that would help somebody. You know, because that's what I'm here for, is to teach and to do tutorials and all that. So, you know, so that's why I was like, even though, not for sure, it's kind of come out and if I'm going to figure it out, I thought, why not figure it out together and we'll figure it out. You know, anyway, that one is empty, but so let me get a primer because I think primers are always like super important on any foundation. And so, what my problem was last night was I didn't get it white enough. It wasn't that it looked bad on my skin or anything. And then it didn't cover. It just wasn't white enough. So, I have this one, and I just used this one, and I put a little bit of a Juvia's Place, which is really pale on me, and I put that in it. But I also found this one. And so I'm gonna put this one and that one, the other one together. And I don't know if I'm gonna put a bit of the Juvia's Place in it. Depends on how well these two work together and how much coverage I get. Cause I wanted the Juvia's Place in it to give it a little more coverage. Cause these two are both very sheer. So we'll see how much coverage I get. You know, cause I don't want it to be sheer. Was my thoughts. But I'm also going to use the Stila One Step primer because I don't have a lot of redness, but I thought that might help cover up the redness that I do have. Since we're supposed to be like white. I mean, I'm already a pretty fair girl, but since I'm supposed to be white, I thought maybe a one-step corrector would kind of cancel out any pigmentation that would be super good. How come when you're recording or doing something, that's when your phone starts getting all these notifications? And so hopefully that kind of helps cancel out any like pigmentation that I might have, so that doesn't come through like the stark white foundation. It was my thoughts, you know, because I do have a little bit like right in here. And I have like glitter all over my face from like a look earlier. So hopefully that's not like too big of an issue. You know, whatever. Yeah. And I do have like some corrector, so I might, you know, I might already go ahead and dab some of the corrector on and just put that over. And then put a white concealer on top of that. So that way I'm not, so that way I can cover up any redness. That I have. I have no idea if this is gonna work. We're just really trying to not have any redness peek through. So now I look super crazy. So if you don't know, green gets rid of red. When you're getting rid of unwanted colors, you go right across from the color wheel, and green is right across from red. So to get rid of green, you go to red, and vice versa. To get rid of purple, you go to yellow. To get rid of orange, you go to blue. Blue to get, orange to get rid of blue. We do that all the time in color correction at the salon. And then I have white concealer, so I'm just gonna like go ahead and kind of dab that over it. And see if that kind of helps. Even before I put my foundation on. We'll see. If that kind of help neutralizes anything. Make that a lot more brighter. Okay, now I'm going to go into the tube other, into the foundations. pause it 1 second. Okay, I'm back. My youngest son came down here. Brit had a question. He was taking out his trash. Okay, I got it pretty worked into my skin. I'm gonna go. Well, now I'll finish it. And then I'll do my brows. Off camera. And braid my hair off camera. And I'll be back to do my eyes. I'll be back. Okay, so I'm back. I got my foundation on my eyebrows, my hair braided. And I've got my bangs clipped back so I can work my eyes. Oh, hold on. Let me be right back. I'm going to zoom you in on my eyes. Now I'm back. For real this time. I almost forgot. You know. I forgot. I'm going to grab my palettes. I should have done that. Why? I didn't have you. You know. Forgetful sometimes. No excuses. Just get my mirror back. So that way, I know sometimes I'm looking down and you guys get my forehead or on the top of my head. It has to be annoying. Like, look up, Tammy, look up. We want to see what you're doing and not your stinking forehead the entire time. I mean, that would be annoying. I mean, I feel like am I doing it now? Kinda. Anyway. And doing the concealer, it must have helped because I am a little whiter. I don't know. It does look better. But I do know one thing I'm super worried about. The foundation moving. Because it's not, you know, it's just. It's not like foundation. So I'm like, and then I don't want to put too much powder because I don't want to, you know. Take away from whiteness. Just, I got problems. I have real problems right now. Our whiteness foundation. And this is certified from the Jaclyn Hill palette. And it's just a white. I mean, like, stark white eyeshadow. which is really good for me right now. Give me some of that. Yay, that's better. Okay, now I'm gonna go in. With my Juvia's coral palette, and I'm gonna go with the lightest gray that's in the palette. And they don't have names in this palette. Kind of concentrating on the outer V and then kind of pushing it over. I'm gonna create the shape that I want because I'm kind of making like a foxy eye. What there, I believe, is the terminology for that. And now I'm going to go with kind of the darker gray to make it really smooth. Once it's blended, let's see how that adds depth to it and just kind of makes it real smokier. Because I'm just trying to add depth. Smoky foxy eye. Just working it out. Lighter shade. This one out. No harsh line. Jaclyn Hill palette into Temptress. It's this black shade right here. I'm sorry. I was looking down. I'm so sorry. I hope I wasn't doing it on the other eye too. Now I'm going to go into the other shade, the darker gray, and kind of just go over the edges. Still, I don't want to get rid of the black. I just want it to be soft. Okay. You just want it to be nice and blended. You want it to be soft, but you don't want it like, you know, like hard lines. If that makes sense. Okay, so now I'm going to go into my paint palette. I'm going to use the white. That one. My gosh, and tomorrow, it's supposed to be like, I don't know how the weather is where you guys are. We're supposed to get like a severe storm. I'm supposed to go in and work tomorrow. I wonder if I'll even actually, I might go in with silver too. Silver. I think I might really like silver better. I'll do both eyes. Go in the darker and then go with the lighter. This is such a yellow white. I don't like that. It kind of takes away. Let's scratch that. So I'm gonna go with this darker gray. Okay, yes. Yes. I like that. Much better. Much. I'm in a happy place now. Now I'm gonna take the lighter ray. This one right here. Again, with the looking down, oh my god. I need a sign on my mirror that says, don't look down, don't look down. Away the powder. Now let's do, okay, let me do eyeliner, which I gotta scoot in. Let's see if I can do this. So the foxy eye kind of comes like down in here and over a little bit. And, you know, I haven't done this a whole lot. So let's pray for me. Take a deep breath. That I can do this and not like make a fool out of myself on camera. Okay. Moment of silence. And I'll probably not talk through this. So... actually, you know, I might do this off camera because I'm going to look down and then you will just see like my forehead. I'll be back. Hi, I am back. My eyes are done and I love them. I really do. I think it turned out really good. I mean, this foundation though is so hard to work with. Like it moves so easily because even if you set it, it like, oh, it's just not... like other foundations. I mean, it's a good thing I don't want to like do blush and contour a lot, you know, because I want to be as pale as possible, but jeez, if you did, I mean, it would be just like, and I didn't even get to talk about the movie because I was concentrating so hard. So, Addams Family, love it. I love the Addams Family values. The first one, I mean, Wednesday Addams is like, oh, that girl who plays her, she was so good. And they, I mean, Morticia also, I mean, all of them were like, perfect. The humor in it, the lines, everything. I have not seen the animation one that they did recently. I mean, let me know who's watched it and who hasn't, and if it is as good as the movies. I want to know what everybody thinks. And then, Ella. Let you know if I decide to watch it. How come putting on like a black lipstick totally makes my like tongue look seem like wow. Anyway, this is my complete look. I'm gonna try to set my method will help move in you. I mean, this foundation is just... ugh, I hate it. I mean, I don't know. Okay, how anybody else feels about like clown foundation, like white foundation. Is it me or am I just being super particular? What was I gonna say about Wednesday Addams? Ooh! In the second one, when she becomes playing Pocahontas, is that not the funniest part? Love that part. Love it. Anyway, so this is the finished look. How do you think I did? Do you feel like I look like Wednesday Addams? Let me know in the comments below. Did I pull it off? Did I not? If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. Hit that notification bell so you know when I upload. And also, please give me a like if you would be so kind. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.